Welcome to RAR Math, How to Factor with Grouping.
Here is an example where it looks like everything, well, everything is written in descending order, which means unlike other examples where you had to switch terms around, this one is pretty straightforward. So if we jump right in and we group by grouping our first two terms together and our second two terms together and bringing down this negative, we see that out of the first two terms, we can pull a 4x squared. And out of the second two terms, we can pull a 2, negative 2. If we pull out a 4x squared, 8 divided by 4 is 2. And if we take away 2 of our x's, we're left with 2x. 4x squared divided by 4x squared, anything divided by itself is 1. You cannot eliminate a term through division. You can only eliminate a term through addition or subtraction. We bring down our minus 2. Negative 4 divided by negative 2 is 2, so 2x. And negative 2 divided by negative 2, anything divided by itself is 1, plus 1. If I look at the parentheses, 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1, I see a lot of students trying to laundry list these parentheses so that the answer becomes 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1, and 4x squared minus 2. You can't do that. On the surface, it looks like the answer to this question is prime, but I missed a really important first step, which is you should always check to see if there's a greatest common factor that comes out. Now, I skipped it on purpose. I did it for two reasons. One, if a four-term polynomial ends up being prime, always double check for your greatest common factor. Really, really important. Sometimes the greatest common factor is easier as a secondary step than a primary step. So if these had been the same and I had written down the 2x, whatever, 1, the second parentheses would have been a 4x squared minus 2, and it would have been really important if I had gotten to that 4x squared minus 2 to realize that I could have pulled a 2 out and that I wasn't done factoring. So you always have to make sure to pull that greatest common factor out. Sometimes you can do it at the, well, you can always do it at the end. Sometimes it's easier at the end because you don't have as many parentheses that you are managing. So knowing that I can't factor this way, I'm gonna come back up to my original problem and see that with an 8, 4, 4, and a 2, I can pull out a 2. And the reason I'm not erasing is because when you're showing your work, it's really nice when teachers know your thought process. And leaving this as part of my work allows someone to go back and see the work I've done and that I've checked different options. And I understood that this meant that it didn't factor by grouping. When I pull out a 2, 8x cubed divided by 2 is 4x cubed. 4x squared divided by 2 is 2x squared. 4x divided by 2 is 2x, and 2 divided by 2 is 1. I kept all the signs the same because I was pulling out a positive 2. Now I see that all of the terms are, well, the whole four-term polynomial is a prime polynomial, and I'm done. If all you can do is factor out a greatest common factor, you have factored. The next mistake I see students make on a problem like this, besides trying to use this purple answer as the correct answer, is saying prime at this point. Because the four-term polynomial is prime, I get a lot of students saying prime, done, and done. But you can't both factor and have it prime. I like to say you either have parentheses or it's prime, not both. You have to be careful. There are times when there would be parentheses in the original problem and it still ends up being prime. But as a quick check, if you have brought in parentheses, you have factored something out, it isn't prime. Thank you, and I hope you have enjoyed and understood this example. Please share it with friends, like the page, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks.